I just wanted a couple final thoughts on the season that's coming up, in particular because of the T20 World Cup and India building up to that. The Dhoni situation, how do you read it? It just seems it seems very intriguing. Here he is. Apparently, the message coming through is he's opting out of this series, but the selectors seem to be saying that it's almost a line in the sand kind of thing. How do you read it, Anil? I mean, is there an exit plan that doesn't seem to be on script from both parties?
I think India, you know, the selectors will have to take a call as to which team will, or which is the likely team that you would want in the World Cup, because the World Cup is just a year away. You would want a consistent team to be playing right throughout. I mean, that's exactly what did not happen in the 50-over competition.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, there were a lot of changes leading up to the World Cup. We were still not sure about who that number four would be. I think the whole World Cup, we kept discussing who should bat at number four in a 50-over competition. That's not what you want leading into a T20 World Cup. You would want all those roles and responsibilities to be fixed and make sure that you have backups for certain positions just in case somebody gets injured or somebody is out of form. So, yes, you know, there would be certainly some discussions about exit plan like what you just mentioned. But having said that, you know, MS Dhoni certainly deserves a proper send-off whenever he decides to move on from the sport. But I think, you know, for the team's sake and for everyone else's sake, I think the selectors need to sit down and have a discussion around what the plans are, because it's important that needs to be communicated. If the selectors believe that MS Dhoni is in the scheme of things for the T20 World Cup, then I think he should be playing every game. If he's not, then I think it's important that they have a discussion around how they need to make this happen. I think they need to do that whenever in the next couple of months to take a call. So, like I mentioned, he certainly deserves a proper send-off whenever that happens. But having said that, the communication channels need to happen from the selectors' end.
So let me try and put you on the spot on this a little bit. Would you have him continue as part of the Indian team now that the World Cup is done and dusted? Would you look at him for another year or not?
I'm not really sure. I think, you know, Rishabh Pant has certainly made a lot of claims as a keeper batsman, especially in the T20 format. So I think it's important to have a conversation. And, you know, like I mentioned, you need to have a proper send-off. He certainly deserves that. So I think you need to have a proper conversation around how you want to do that. But having said that, Rishabh certainly has shown that. He has also shown some inconsistencies. So that's a call that the selectors need to make today, that in spite of all of that, you know, are you going to back him or somebody else? Or will you look back? You know, I wouldn't.